The Philippine Supreme Court holds off from halting the implementation of the law which created the country's sovereign wealth fund. Sources told ABS-CBN News Wednesday that the court instead ordered the executive and legislative branches to comment on the request for a temporary restraining order. Critics asked the court last month to strike down the law for the Maharlika Investment Fund's creation. They assailed the lack of cause for President Marcos's certification of the measure as urgent in Congress. The government's chief lawyer vowed a thorough study on the petition. As for the House, Speaker Martin Romualdez said they would file their comment at the soonest possible time. He also insisted on their intention to ensure financial transparency and accountability. For an analyst, the unprecedented ouster of Speaker McCarthy indicates the disintegration of the Republican Party. Princeton University historian Sean Willens told Reuters, McCarthy's ouster is a victory for Donald Trump. He also believes the ultimate goal of Republicans is a government shutdown, which they will blame on President Joe Biden.
What we're seeing today is the latest installment in the, you know, ever continuing coup d'etat by Donald Trump. I mean, that's what we're seeing. And it's pretty clear that he's the hidden hand in a lot of this stuff that's been going on, that I think probably the next step would be a shutdown, which is really what they're probably aiming for. They wanted to get McCarthy out of there in part because he stood in the way of that. Bunch of reasons, but that's part of it. And it's the politics of chaos.
A small committee formed by the Philippine House of Representatives should resolve amendments to the 2024 national budget by next week. According to House Appropriations Committee Chair Elizalde Co., the ad hoc committee noted several budget items for amendment or realignment during its meeting Tuesday. Co earlier said the House would increase funding for intelligence agencies and the Fisheries Bureau to improve the country's monitoring and operations in the West Philippine Sea. The confidential funds of the Vice President's Office and Education Department are among the line items that will be affected. The House approved the 5.7 trillion peso budget for 2024 last week.
More news. The Philippines eager to conclude within the year a defense deal with Japan similar to the Visiting Forces Agreement. Defense Secretary Gilbert Teodoro Jr. says the Reciprocal Access Agreement, or RAA, is still with the Department of Foreign Affairs Department, but will need the Senate's approval as it is a treaty with another country. The defense chief says he wants to fast-track the agreement. The RAA will establish guidelines for activities of the visiting force during cooperative activities. Once ratified, the Philippines joins Australia and the United Kingdom, which have an existing RAA with Japan.
The Philippine Department of Migrant Workers says it is still waiting for an official report on the death of Filipino worker Margaret Garcia in Saudi Arabia. The OFW was found dead with stab wounds. Details of Garcia's death remain scarce as Saudi authorities investigate the incident.
Sa ngayon ay nag-aantay pa ho tayo ng official report mula sa Saudi authorities. At ito pong inaantabayanan natin. Ang latest po dito ay umabot na po sa prosecutor at papunta na po sa korte. Inaantahan ho namin na ang ulat ay lalabas na, kundi man ngayon ay kasusunod na araw.
The victim's family is also appealing for more information surrounding Garcia's death.
Ada Votas court orders the arrest of cops involved in the murder of 17-year-old Jemboy Baltasar. The policemen are facing murder charges and are not entitled to bail. Baltasar was killed in August after police mistook him for a murder suspect. 8 policemen have been dismissed from the service due to that incident.
The country's privacy watchdog closely monitoring the dark web for a possible dump of data from PhilHealth. PhilHealth has been insisting its database remains intact and that personal information of members are safe after getting hit with a ransomware attack. But the ICT department earlier said hackers already leaked some data of PhilHealth members online after Tuesday's ransom deadline lapsed. For the National Privacy Commission, PhilHealth should ultimately be held accountable for its failure to protect the data of its members and employees.
So we're investigating whether or not there was a possible negligence in the processing of personal information, if there are security lapses, if PhilHealth will not report if there are personal data that were compromised that might amount to concealment. In this case, I think it would be what would be applicable if the determination whether or not appropriate security measures were put in place. If that would not amount to negligence, maybe it would amount to possible administrative fines. The fine would reach up to 5 million pesos.